Hi, welcome to my studio, Art by Mojo. I'm Darlene, and today I'm working on a very large sea turtle. This is 19 by 26, and I wanted to show you how I did this part of the turtle shell. It's different from animal fur like I've done in the past. This is a very smooth looking finish. So these are the pastels that I'm using, and I'm going to pick the two darkest, which would be these two, and these are the two I'm going to work with first. And this is my image that I'm going by. You can see it's much smaller. You have to pay attention to what direction your shell is going in. See the pattern? It goes this way, then it turns and goes this way. It's almost like a burst of starburst, if you will. So you're going to lay the colors in that way. And they don't have to be photorealistic. Let's get some light on the subject. I am going to lay this paper here just so my hand doesn't smear the face and front arm of the turtle. And I'm just going to lay these in. Like I said, they don't have to be perfect. We're not going for photorealism. Just similar. You want to still want to rotate your pencil just like you were if you were making fur. You can do it on the side. I had to make this tabletop because the paper was so big it wouldn't fit on my regular table. So I have to clamp it onto my table. It's a little awkward to move around. So that's why I'm trying to twist my pencil around. Just going to put these two colors down. Bear with me a moment. And if you're not familiar with this paper, this is Claire Fontaine Pastel Matte. It's kind of like a sandpaper. It has a little grit on it, which is what holds the pastel in it. But now, those colors are going to be very subdued in a moment. And I'll have to lay them in there again because, as you can see, the paper is slightly showing through. I have my base background already on there when we started this. So I'm going to take this stump and I'm just going to push these into the fibers of the paper. It also blends them as we do it, but it also dulls them, as you can see. But if I don't push these in, the next layer might not grab that tooth. And I haven't done the fine detail on this piece as of yet. So it'll look quite different when I get the finished product done. I'm trying not to hit these outer parts of the shell. Okay, now if we look at the image, right in here, you'll see that there's some darker browns and blacks, some of those rich browns you just cannot get in pastels. So when I run across that, I use black underneath. Again, just laying the pencil on its side, and I'm not pushing down hard, I'm just dragging it. And there's a little black up here, or dark brown. And then there's a little right in here. And here. Still, I'm going in the same direction. As you can see, I kept all these going. You would think all of them would go in one direction coming down the turtle's back, but it doesn't. It twists and turns. Okay, now I'm going to take the brown and go back on top of that black, and you can see it takes the graininess away because I've laid another layer on there. but that makes that a much richer brown. I don't like using my finger too much. Okay, we're gonna switch to my lighter colors now. Still, I'm gonna go in this order, starting here, here, then here. This is the final one, so I'm actually gonna lay it aside. But these three I'll work with now, because right now that's very dull. See, now I can lay that color in there. There's no graininess because I've gotten enough pigment down into those fibers that it takes the graininess away. And before I get too far across, I'm gonna go in and lay this other color on top of that. Not all parts of it. I'm gonna even put a little bit on the black. But you want this to look like it's a burst of color. And then the light one on top, a little. Don't want to get too much of this because he is under the water. You're going to have some highlights like these, but you're not going to have that. Here, I'm using the word burst again. Burst of color like you would on a turtle if he was out of the water, where the sun's hitting his wet shell, his head, or whatever, and reflecting off of it. This turtle is deep in the sea and there's no light really bouncing off him that much. This is my second turtle. This is the largest one. I did one just a few inches smaller. And I'll be honest with you, it takes me longer to do the coral and the sea bottom than it does for the turtle, which I think is hilarious because the turtle's the feature. Again, you can see how the graininess is going away, and where I see there is grain, I make sure I go over that area. You don't want it to look grainy, you want it to look smooth. If it looks too grainy, the turtle's going to look like he's growing a hair under the water. I'm gonna add a little bit of dark right there, I just noticed. And this paper is called sand, the color, in case anyone needs to know that. I got a little too much of that goldish yellow color, this one. So I'm just going over a little bit with this darker shade of orange. Okay. And you see how I have this spot here, few darker. I want to warm this one up a little bit, so I'm going to put another layer of black just very lightly on top of that. And tone it back down just a little. You may think it's redundant, but all these layers that you put on here just make it come to life. That's what I love about pastels. You can just layer and layer. Okay. Now to get these extra highlights here, I use this one. This pastel, it's a Carbothello number 205. I don't know what you're thinking. Oh my gosh, that's too yellow. The turtle don't have yellow on it. There is a hint of yellow in the sea turtles. But just do it like that. And this is probably my favorite pencil. Every pencil I have, it's Saffron by Derwent. I don't like Derwent because they're hard to sharpen, but some of their flesh tones are just awesome. And this is one of them I just love. I put that over the yellow. You know, it's a little bit showing of the yellow, it's okay. Okay. So then the other thing I wanted to show you was on his head and the arms. You can see I've got some pastel out here, but I haven't started the background. This is a Pitt pastel number 103. And I'm not always going to tell you the numbers that are on the pencils because you have to pick and choose yourself. But this is the one I use for turtle shells. And I love it because it's not yellow, it's not white, it's not gray. It's just kind of right there in the middle. We're going to put these dividers in. And I'm having a glance over at my reference photo to make sure I put these at the right spot. Sometimes you have to do more than one pass. Make sure you curve them when they're curved and leave them off when they're not there. Most turtle shells have a little split along the side. Some places, not always. And I'm pushing rather hard because there are multiple layers of pastels that I'm going on top of. And maybe I could have left this. Well, this is not a real solid line here. So I'm gonna do like little brush strokes. But it is that hint of the very brightest color the turtle has. Okay, even though you can't see it, right here is a space. And while I'm just doing this, if you can click the like button below, it doesn't cost you anything. I'd greatly appreciate it. It helps. Before I go any further, right here's a little highlighted area, a reflection of something in the water. So I'm going to add that in while I'm there. And there's one right there. But when you click the like button, it is what shows YouTube how active a video is and whether or not they show it, like when people will type in turtle, will they show my drawing today? So that doesn't cost you anything. And if you subscribe, it's going to ask for your email information, which is normal for most things nowadays. But that's still not going to cost you anything. And that way, when I do a new video, you'll get a notice. Hey, the more people you subscribe to, the more you learn. Okay, there's a little, maybe that's a little crack in his shell. not exactly a shape, it's close. This one just kind of vanishes. Same for this direction, it just kind of vanishes. Pops back in a little bit right over here. And this will look totally different when the water's added. Right, here's another little crack in his shell. Sea turtles have long lives, but they also have a lot of battles. Okay, I don't like the width that that line is becoming. It's okay, as big as this is. So I use a little hand sharpener. I've tried, I think, 5 different electric and crank sharpeners. I'm not satisfied with any of them. The swordfish is probably better than any of them. But I've been buying these little cheap sharpeners. Get like 48 for $7. And that's these, and this was at the Dollar Tree. I think there was 12 for a dollar, 6 for a dollar, but I just use them and throw them away. Okay, back to his shell. This comes over and has a little, another crack there, and faint little, and if you want it to be softer, just touch it a couple of times. This one goes this way, and it's, get it a little bit more pronounced, then I'll dull it down. You just touch it slightly, it becomes softer. Okay, but you can see he's coming along. Some of this excess out here is no big deal. The blue will cover it up. But this glassing paper comes with every sheet of pastel mat you buy when you buy it in a tablet. When I buy in big sheets like this, it doesn't come with glassing paper. But this is great to lay over it, lay your hand on it. It will take some of the pastel, but it will not smear it. So there's my turtle, probably about 80% done. And I hope you enjoyed this video and you'll come back and visit my site more often. Thank you.